Hello, welcome to the award-winning Lee Pitts Live on radio. I'm Lee Pitts, the longtime host of the Lee Pitts Live TV show. I'm so thrilled to have you join us for these magnificent conversations on WGGM 90.5 FM, where Southwest Florida community comes to be informed and meet our game changers weekdays from noon to 1 p.m. and from 6 o'clock to 7 p.m. with over 25,000 interviews under my belt. People always ask me, Lee, what's your favorite interview? That's simple. It's the next one. And it's right here on Lee Pitts Live on radio. Let's get to it.
This is the award-winning Lee Pitts Live.
Brought to you by the North Law Firm. For accidents and negligent security cases, call Joe at 239-337-1191.
Southwest Florida, welcome back. We are here at the famed Gateway High School, and we're so happy to have leaders of this high school who have taken time out to grace our TV set right here at Gateway High School. We have the principal, Mrs. Watson, and we have the athletic director, Mr. Double D. Let's bump y'all in. See there? When you're at school, you have to try to use the Mr. and Mrs. stuff and don't call you by first name. I'm so happy to be here at Gateway High School. Ms. Watson, thanks for rolling out the red carpet accommodations for our television show.
Thank you. Thank you for coming.
What's it like to have Lee Pitts Live here for a day at Gateway?
It's amazing. You know, the staff, they're very excited that you're here. So we just wanted to make things nice for you and your guests.
Well, I want you to know, after doing this show for 31 years and going to so many places throughout Southwest Florida being hosted as a television show, this has been number one in terms of accommodations. Tell staff they're number one.
I will.
And I've said
that
it on television.
Our day.
Of the hundreds and hundreds of places.
All right,
you love winning.
Thank you. Speaking of
winning, Gateway High School has a winning spirit coach, athletic director. Would you also be coaching as well with the title of athletic director?
Oh, no. As of our new position in the district this year, we are no longer allowed to coach.
Okay.
I don't know how former ADs did it before. Just the job that we have, I don't know how they would do both. So that's just mind-blowing to me.
People probably don't know that a athletic director does so many other things that we don't know. Tell us what we don't know.
Well, what you do know is I'm probably the hardest person to find on campus because I'm running around sometimes literally sprinting through campus to get things done. Whether it's the hours, setting games up, getting budgets set, ordering, and then the simple task of organizing all the athletics and events on the school and activities, whether it's clubs or sports. It's a big job, but I love my job.
You're relatively new here at Gateway High?
Yep.
What's your background?
I was a classroom teacher at Riverdale for 15 years, and then I was the athletic director at Island Coast High School for 3 before coming here this year.
Mm-hmm. What's been your opinion and thoughts about being able to recruit such an experienced educator to that particular position, Ms. Watson?
Well, what made me excited about Mr. Doubledy is that he said that being an athletic director is his dream job and Gateway High School is his dream school. So once we have someone who's passionate about the position, we'll do great things here.
That sounds like he rehearsed that.
Well, it's true. When I first found out, I live in Gateway, when I first found out the school was being built in 2017, the plans, I was like, that's where I want to be. That's definitely where I want to be. And I've always wanted to be in this position. I'll say it again, I love my job. Mm-hmm. Absolutely love it.
Outstanding. When people think about Gateway High School, Ms. Watson, what are some things you want to come to their mind that distinguishes this high school from other high schools?
Children first. All students matter. All students have a place here at Gateway High School, and our goal is preparing scholars for college, career, and life after high school.
Mm-hmm. You said college, career, and life after high school, which
yes.
means that you understand that every student is not going to go to college. There are other career paths. Do you guys embrace that as well?
Absolutely, and we were designed with that in mind. So we have several career academies where students could leave high school, go straight into the workforce, and make money. We have a carpentry academy, medical, vet, engineering, and I always leave one off. What am I missing?
Is it graphics?
Computer programming.
Computer programming.
Okay. So when one moves around in this high school, they will see all of those different activities going on. Is it blended with into the curriculum of a normal school day? Some of those vocational type things I just mentioned. The word vocational doesn't really fit, but that's for lack of a better word.
Yes, it is part of their normal school day. All of the classes are here on campus, and they're considered elective classes.
Oh, I see. Okay, so back to sports. We're sitting here taping this on a Friday. You got football tonight. Football is still king in high school, or you kind of put them all on an equal level?
Football, in terms of exposure, is king. It definitely is king in high school.
Can't feel on that one.
Yeah. But I will say here we have an equal emphasis on the success of all sports. Football can run the show at every school. Anybody that says it doesn't probably doesn't have a football team.
Mm-hmm.
But in terms of focus, as we build and grow at this school, we are building and growing and facilitating every sport we possibly can. We're adding beach volleyball this year. We have beach volleyball courts. We're looking at adding girls flag football in the spring. I've had students come up to me about boys volleyball. I've had students come up to me about boys and girls lacrosse. And then the clubs that kids have to participate in here. We have 20 plus clubs. And you don't see that at every high school. And we get kids every single day looking and asking about more.
Mm-hmm.
What else can we do? So just the simple involvement of students, not just in sports, but in activities, is unprecedented.
Mm-hmm. You talked about some of the programs that you're adding, athletically speaking. Talk about your basics that are here as well.
So we have the standards in the fall: football, volleyball, swimming, cross country, bowling, boys and girls bowling. One of our shining squads is boys basketball that we talked a little bit off air, and the success as a first year program in the building. This is only our second year as a
physical
building.
I think you went to the state or city?
Yeah, we won the district title last year.
One year.
Sophomores and juniors. So mostly freshmen, sophomores, zero underclassmen. So this year we're looking to continue to grow with everybody coming back. So basketball has been our big shining light. But girls basketball, we're growing there. We're going to have varsity, JV, and maybe even enough players for freshman team. Like I said, we're adding beach volleyball in the spring, track, all these other programs, boys and girls soccer, baseball, softball, 90 plus kids coming out or signing up with interest for each team. It's unbelievable.
That is tremendous. What do you attribute to that, Ms. Watson? Is it location? Is it the size of the school, the reputation, or a combination there too?
I think it's a combination of it all, but kids want to be involved. You know, that's a big attractor. That's why most of our kids, well, a lot of kids come to school because the involvement in sports and clubs.
Mm-hmm. Can't get past that. Mm-hmm. That's a good thing as long as they make that academics number one. You mentioned a swimming program. Did I miss something? Is there a swimming pool here as well?
We do not have a swimming pool on campus yet.
Mm-hmm.
We use an off-campus pool, but yeah, swimming is huge.
Okay. Well, I didn't go to a high school with a swimming pool, and I wish I did, but I still was able to get it done. Let's go back to you, Ms. Watson. Let's talk about the size, faculty, and the number of students who are actually here. You are a high school freshman through senior year.
Yes.
And I remember when I interviewed you here before the school even opened, I did a show here when it was all beams and everything. People are looking at some images of that now on screen. At that time, it was you were trying to hire staff. Now you are fully staffed, or people listening now interested in careers, this may be a place they may consider working.
Yes, we need teachers. We have a great environment. We work as a team here, but we are growing. Last time you interviewed, I think we only had ninth graders only. So
okay.
It was about 400 ninth graders. Last year we had 1,300 students. Right now we're sitting at over 2,000 students. So
man,
we have grown. And we have about 95 teachers. They love working here. They come to work every day. They do not miss work. So Gateway is a nice place to work.
Is that max, that number you named in terms of number of students?
Well, our capacity is 2,200. So we'll be looking to get about 200 more students next year.
Not your little mom and pop school like I grew up in.
No.
The graduations take place here at this school?
Or
you go off campus?
Lee County graduations are off campus.
Okay. Explain to our viewing audience where we are physically right now. I know people seeing all the nice black and they see the logo in the background there. Where are we?
This is called a black box theater. So it's not an auditorium like most schools have. It's a black box. So this is front and center on our campus, and this is where we have theater productions. So if we bring parents in, this is the location.
Okay. And now, a word from our sponsors.
Been in an accident that wasn't your fault, and you need a personal injury consultant, an expert helping recover your losses. Joe Nor, you was a victim on someone else's property. Been having complications due to some doctoring. You want a lawyer that wanna see you prospering. Joe Nor, you not only retain a lawyer, you gain a forever friend who gon' do his best for you to ensure you a win. Been serving the state of Florida 30 plus years, and his passion for helping people one can only commend. If your employer discriminates, call Joe. Word miscompensation procrastinate. Call Joe. Wrong for death been in your family lately. Call Joe. Joe Nor.
Joe North has been practicing law in the state of Florida for over 30 years, representing thousands across our community after an accident. Committed and dedicated to ensure you get the justice you deserve. For free consultations, you can contact Joe at area code 239-337-1191 or toll free at 866-41-NORTH.
The overall goal of the Fort Myers CRA is to improve the conditions of our redevelopment areas. This impacts our citizens all over the city of Fort Myers. We do this by strategically implementing the redevelopment plans. We assist existing businesses and incentivize and attract new business development. These incentives result in growing our tax base, allowing us to generate tax increment that goes directly into our redevelopment areas. The Fort Myers CRA is working to revitalize our redevelopment areas, and we're doing this by advancing businesses, transforming communities, and redeveloping Fort Myers for the future.
I'm Dr. Cindy Banier, Democratic candidate for U.S. House of Representatives, Florida Congressional District 19. I'm a teacher and small business owner. I'm fighting for the things we need: clean water, good health, and good jobs. I'm here with you and for you. Let's create a Southwest Florida where the sun shines on everyone. Send me to Congress to work for you. Check your voter registration and vote for me, Dr. Cindy Banier.
I'm Cindy Banier and I approve this message.
Neuropsychiatric Research Center of Southwest Florida is a center of excellence that has been conducting clinical research studies for Alzheimer's disease, dementia, and memory loss for over 20 years. These studies play a major role in the development of new medications and treatments and may provide benefits to current participants as well as future generations. Qualified participants may receive access to study-related care and medication from our team of medical professionals at no cost, as well as compensation for time and travel. To learn more, call 239-309-2116.
Here is where we're from. Here made us who we are. Here is where we learn relationships are worth more than dollars can measure. It's a value that grows over time, strengthens under pressure, and thrives when serving others. We're Synovus, and we're here for our community because we live here too. Synovus, the bank of here.
AHF is proud to provide HIV testing, care, and counseling to the Fort Myers community. For years, AHF has provided locals with a wide range of healthcare services regardless of their ability to pay. These services include convenient pharmacy access, compassionate case management, regular testing, and steady treatment. In addition to our healthcare center, our Fort Myers location offers free wellness services that provide routine STI testing, STI treatment, linkage to specialty HIV care, community referrals, and access to PrEP. Visit the AHF Fort Myers Healthcare Center and Wellness Center by calling 239-210-9980. We proudly provide Ryan White services.
You're listening to Lee Pitts Live on radio on WGGM 90.5 FM.
Because it looks like it's big enough for a basketball game, but this is, I thought I might be, this might be where you can convert it to a basket, but you got a gym for that too,
yes,
right?
Yes, we do.
So the next time we come, we may be sitting in the gym at the half court mark. I'm lobbying for that.
Yeah.
But right now in that gym, it's really active, right? If I was sitting in there right now, students would be running all over the place.
Oh yeah, you'd be bobbing and weaving, basketballs, dodgeballs, kids nonstop. Mm-hmm. Back to the black box, the utility of this space is unlike any other. Whether it be meetings with parents or faculty nights or student nights or plays or productions, we could also host things like wrestling matches from an athletic standpoint in here. Mm-hmm. Dim the lights, make it a really cool atmosphere.
And you could bring in a portable stage? Is that the way it works?
Well, I'm bringing my mats and put them right there front and center.
Okay.
Yep.
And also school dances. The students want to hold dances here, but I'm not ready for that yet.
You're just so nervous. Safety number one, huh?
Yep, safety number one.
And at getting 2,000 students or 2,200, if it gets to that out of school, the logistics of that, it has to be coordinated very well. And I think you guys got that down to a science.
We're getting there. You know, we're experiencing the growing pains. We're right off of Griffin Drive in 82, and it does get backed up. But we do get students in the building and out of the building quickly and safely.
How does one become a student here at Gateway? Do you have to live in a certain district? If you want to come play sports here, you have to be zoned here, your school choice. Starting with you, Mr. Athletic Director.
So to be a student here, you got to live in the East Zone, and then it's a matter of school choice, picking which schools you'd want to choose from between Eastley, Riverdale, Dunbar, and Lehigh, and then you get assigned through student assignment. There's a lot of other factors that will determine if you get your first choice, which we are the number one chosen school in Lee County.
In the history of school choice.
Yeah.
You mean more students?
More students select Gateway High School as their number one choice than any other school in the district.
Really?
Yes.
And then they go from there?
Then they go from there.
So you say the maximum is 2,200. Why aren't you at 2,200 if you got a waiting list?
We do have a waiting list. The waiting list is, last I checked, 300 students, but we are capped as well. So right now we have about 700 freshmen, so we're capped there. 10th graders, we have about 650 juniors, but our senior class is very small.
Mm-hmm. So right, always is.
Yep.
Is that directly the capping that is that a direct correlation to the amount of faculty that you have?
No, it's about the capacity of the building. Mm-hmm.
Let me hear about your college prep courses. I know at your other school you won an award. You were like an avid school.
I'm trying to come up
with this terminology. See?
We were
Are you an avid? Can be an avid as well?
Yes. In fact, the high school before my last high school was an avid demo school. My last school, which was Lehigh Acres Middle School, was an avid demonstration school. We are an avid school. Right now, we are not currently seeking demo status.
Okay. Yep. Whatever that means. Academics, sports. Talk about the way you guys tie all that together and the emphasis on academics leading?
Well, first things first with academics and the students, I quickly learned that academics rules all. Academics is the number one priority. Here they truly are student athletes, and it's apparent in the verbiage used. Students aren't necessarily referred to as students, and if you hear the common vernacular here, you'll hear Ms. Watson, Principal Watson, call everybody scholars. That's how they're addressed here. To really focus on that student-scholar achievement, and then the focus is on athletics for the athletes on campus. We have the basic rules from the Florida High School Athletic Association. 2.0 is the minimum standard, but we have programs here where coaches set, if you don't have a 3.0 or better, you're in tutoring. If you don't have a 2.75 or better, you're in tutoring. There's another program that says you got to have a 3.25 before, if you want to practice regularly and not be in tutoring.
What does tutoring look like here? Is that an after-school program?
After-school, teachers help out. Teachers help students with their core classes. But that, again, reflects on the teachers we have here that really, truly want to be here and love being here, that they're going to go that extra mile for our students. And not just our scholar athletes, but all of the scholars here on campus.
Talk about opportunities here to sponsor Principal Watson. People can get involved with your school in various ways. I know the North Law Firm, Joe North, has been involved with their sport program. But just talk about some different ways that the community here and outside of here can support your school.
Yes, so we do have a sponsorship program that Mr. Dubberty oversees. So anyone from the community or business world could sponsor any of our sports programs. They can get their banners and logos on our football field, on our marquee outside. You want to?
Yeah, I call it the community partnership program. Because that's what we really want to do is create partners, not just in Gateway, but we get kids from all over Lehigh as well. I think because of our name, people just instantly associate the school with Gateway Boulevard, which is fine, which is great, and other communities there. But we have a lot of people pulling from the Lehigh community, and we want to make sure that they're represented as well. So when we're talking community partnerships, anything is available that people want to advertise, be part of this growing school, whether it's, as Principal Watson said, banners or social media shout outs that we have multiple social media accounts, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
I'm expecting a whole lot of Lee Pitt Live shout outs right now.
I got you. I got you in the Gateway Athletic site. We have opportunities where a business partner, community partner can sponsor a 40 by 50 foot windscreen on the back of our baseball stadium where that shows to everybody on 82 up to 25,000 cars a week. So, and that's the only advertising on 82. So that's an exclusive, right? So we have lots of opportunities, whether it's the school, whether it's specific teams, whether it's specific projects, people can get involved, and we would love for more and more people to get involved.
Sounds like it. Well, it's been a pleasure having you both on the show, but before I let you go, got to talk college. I want to go straight to you again, Principal Watkins. Let's talk colleges. Are colleges coming here recruiting? How do these students get from here to college? Are you having college career days here? Are you making sure historical black colleges know about this school? Go.
Absolutely. So, you know, this year is our first graduating class here, but we do have several college preparatory programs to prepare our students for college. So we have the Cambridge program, where students are taking college classes here on campus, and if they pass tests, they get a full Bright Future scholarship where they can go to a college and it's paid for. We also have a partnership with Florida Gulf Coast University. We're the only school in the East Zone that has this. So at the end of students' 10th grade year, they can apply to be a part of this program. If they are accepted, they are full-time Florida Gulf Coast University students and full-time Gateway High School students. Mm. So when they complete the program, they can get a full scholarship to Florida Gulf Coast University, and school is paid for.
Outstanding.
Yes.
Well, I think after I take this sip, we'll bump you out.
All right.
It's been a pleasure having you both on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
As the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like these fine administrators here at Gateway High School who are doing it. And remember, Miami may have the oranges, but Gateway High School has got the
juice.
You got the juice. We'll be right back.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Been in an accident that wasn't your fault, and you need a personal injury consultant, an expert helping recover your losses. Joe Noah, you was a victim on someone else's property. Been having complications due to some doctoring. You want a lawyer that wanna see you prospering. Joe Noah, you not only retain a lawyer, you gain a forever friend who gon' do his best for you to ensure you a win. Been serving the state of Florida 30 plus years, and his passion for helping people one can only commend. If your employer discriminates, call Joe. Word miscompensation, procrastinate. Call Joe. Wrong for death, been in your family lately. Call Joe. Joe Noah.
Joe North has been practicing law in the state of Florida for over 30 years, representing thousands across our community after an accident. Committed and dedicated to ensure you get the justice you deserve. For free consultations, you can contact Joe at area code 239-337-1191 or toll free at 866-41-NORTH.
Neuropsychiatric Research Center of Southwest Florida is a center of excellence that has been conducting clinical research studies for Alzheimer's disease, dementia, and memory loss for over 20 years. These studies play a major role in the development of new medications and treatments and may provide benefits to current participants as well as future generations. Qualified participants may receive access to study-related care and medication from our team of medical professionals at no cost, as well as compensation for time and travel. To learn more, call 239-309-2116.
Here is where we're from. Here made us who we are. Here is where we learn relationships are worth more than dollars can measure. It's a value that grows over time, strengthens under pressure, and thrives when serving others. We're Synovus, and we're here for our community because we live here too. Synovus, the bank of here.
Hello, I'm Teresa Watkins Brown, candidate for re-election, Fort Myers City Council, Ward 1. Change is constant, but one thing that has not changed is my commitment to the Ward 1 community and building better communities in Ward 1. With over 35 projects that has improved our streetlights, sidewalks, parks, drainage, and sewage, I continue to be the voice that listen, act, and work for the Ward 1 community. We now have a newly renovated Billy Bolex Park and a future renovation for phase 2 of Roberta Clemente Park that will house our Black Cultural Center. Continue to let me be the voice that speak for you. Re-elect Teresa Watkins Brown, Fort Myers City Council, Ward 1. I am Teresa Watkins Brown, and I approve this message.
Join me. Call 239-281-0198.
Hi, I'm Jeffrey Roberts.
And I'm Plachette Roberts.
And we are All America Social Security Disability Representation, LLC. With over 30 years of experience successfully representing clients nationally for disability benefits, we're here for you if you've ever been denied or in the process of applying.
This is not just our vocation, but also our ministry. We know that it's not only about your health and finances, but your spiritual and emotional needs as well.
For a free consultation, please call us at 720-475-0440.
Information on an unsolved crime or a wanted fugitive, but don't want to be seen talking to law enforcement or getting involved in something that you really have nothing to do with? Does the sound of getting cash for your information sound like something you'd be interested in? If so, the only place to turn is Southwest Florida Crime Stoppers. When you submit a tip, you're always anonymous, we don't trace or record your calls, and if your information leads to an arrest, we'll pay a cash reward of up to $3,000. It's just that easy. Do your part to help keep our community safe or earning money at the same time. The Crime Stoppers hotline is open 24/7 at 1-800-780-TIPS, or you can submit a tip online at www.southwestfloridacrimestoppers.com or on the P3 Tips mobile app. Crime Stoppers is how you can make a difference. Paid by CSTF.
Southwest Florida, you caught me. Just before I do any of my television shows, I always read the community press so I can know what's going on in Southwest Florida. So Lee Pitts for Lee Pitts Live reads the community press, and you should too.
You are listening to Lee Pitts Live on radio on WGGM 90.5 FM. Southwest Florida, welcome back to Lee Pitts Live. We are so thrilled to have here in the studio my Haitian sister. We are here at Gateway High School, the famed high school, and the accommodations have been just outstanding thanks to the principal, Nikita Watson. Let's bump in Beatrice Jaquette Castor.
Thank you, Mr. Lee. How are you?
It's good to get you here, my Haitian sister, Sapa Bie.
Ça va bien?
Comment allez-vous?
Bien, et toi?
Ça passe?
On a boulé.
I'm saying, am I saying the same thing over and over?
Yes. You are saying the same thing over.
That's
but
your fault. I should be more fluent in French and Creole.
You keep digressing.
I'm going backwards.
We try. Well, yeah, but you're doing great. You're doing great. And you have made a very good effort to learning the language. You're doing good.
Do I still have my honorary title?
Yes, you do.
Haitian.
Yes, you do.
All right, as long as I got
my
honorary title.
You do.
It has been a minute since you've been here because you haven't had your gala in a while because of the pandemic. Now you're back up and running.
We're super excited about our
gala. I will tell you that from my experience, and I've gone to a lot of events over the years hosting this show for 30 years, is that your gala is one of the best galas that I have ever been to. You guys put on a magnificent gala at the Broadway Palms Dinner Theater, and it's for a great cause. Tell people the what, when, and where this year.
Okay, my Haitian brother, this year we're celebrating our fifth annual scholarship gala at the Broadway Palms on Monday, October 25th. The doors are opening at 5 o'clock. This year, we're gonna have one of our, I call our Haitian Beyonce, by the name of Richelle Gilliam, that's gonna perform at our gala. We're also going to honor a couple of local organizations that have shared our mission and vision and by promoting education to our students. So we are looking forward to it. We have silent auction. We have the silent auction committee that's working on phenomenal baskets. Those are gonna be available probably 3 days, 4 days before the gala. And so this year we're looking forward to having a wonderful program.
Let's go back to the Haitian Beyonce. And I want you to stay seated right there so the camera won't get covered there. The Haitian Beyonce, she is that big in the, how did you get the Haitian Beyonce to come to Fort Myers?
Well, we reached out to her, and I have to give all the credit to Falia Justima.
Okay.
Falia Justima is our...
My good friend.
Yes, your good friend and our MC for our gala. She's part of our coalition. She reached out to Richelle Gilliam, and Richelle accepted to come on Monday, October 21st at the Broadway Palms, and we are super excited. She's going to be here with her team, and we'll be performing at the gala that night. And it's for a good cause, as we are providing scholarships to our Haitian heritage students.
And that, one of the things that I know about your program is those scholarships gets to those students. Sometimes I think we see them come up on the stage. It is not some flim-flammy thing where you never see the results of the labor. Those students get those scholarships. Tell us a success story, and how many scholarships have you given out already? And I think this may be your fifth annual.
This is our fifth annual. Every year, ever since we started the gala, we have been able to give out at least 4 to 5 scholarships per year to local high school students that are graduating in Southwest Florida high schools. The students, almost all of our high school students. I have gone to pursue a post-secondary education, have graduated. We have Daphne Jocelyn now that is a registered nurse, and hopefully she'll be moving back home. We also have a couple of students that is at University of Southwest Florida that are doing phenomenal. So therefore we are keeping up, following up with them and making sure that they are being very successful. And we're so happy and proud that we could play a small part of the students' education.
In a simple way, I know you have on your flyer, you have like 100 phone numbers that people can call to get tickets. In this particular case, let's just give them one phone number, one website they can go to, one Facebook page.
We have a big coalition.
Hey, bitch, I'm so glad you let me have some fun sometimes. Man, you so cool. You like, okay. You know it's 100 numbers on there.
The good thing is, during the pandemic, about last year, a year ago, we opened our office, our Haitian Coalition office that's located in a landmark building.
Right.
3949 Evans Avenue, Suite 304. And we are in Fort Myers. So therefore now they can call the office. Our okay. office phone number is 239-202-8955. Mm-hmm. Or if somebody wanna talk to me directly, speak with me directly, they can call my cell phone, which is 239-878-5898. So therefore you don't have, if you would like to speak to any of the board members, you can call our office and we would provide that number.
Okay, so you have opportunities to purchase tables,
yes.
individual tickets,
yes.
and the great sponsorship levels. I'm always so happy that Lee Pitts Live is a media sponsor of your event. And people, if you are a sponsor, you get a lot of exposure. They bring you up on the big screen. They talk about you. It's really a great thing to be a sponsor as well. And when they get in touch with you at those numbers that you talked about, they can get more details on that.
They can get more details, Lee, if they get a hold of it, when they get a hold of us. In addition to that, our event sponsorship tables and tickets are available on Eventbrite as well for purchase.
Oh, okay.
They can go on Eventbrite or on Eventbrite and pull our event. And they can purchase their sponsorship tables on our Eventbrite as well, or they can come to our office and do that as well.
Mm-hmm. What do you hope that when people attend your gala, what do they take away from that event?
What I would like them to take away is the education that we provide about our culture mm-hmm. and about the Haitian heritage and how we play a big role in the community as well.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Hi, I'm Dr. William Glover, Senior Pastor of Mount Hermon Ministries.
And I'm Pastor Cheryl Glover, First Lady and Business Administrator.
Mount Hermon is a progressive ministry with contemporary praise and worship, life-changing teaching from the Word of God, and opportunities to serve the Kingdom of God and our community in tangible ways.
The Dew of Hermon Early Learning Center serves children, infants to 4 years old. Our programs include Early Head Start, VPK, School Readiness, and free meals for every child.
For adult learners, join us at Life Christian University, where you can earn an associate, bachelor's, master's, or doctorate degree in several ministry-related fields.
We are Mount Hermon Ministries,
having a redeeming influence in our community.
Come join us.
In Southwest Florida, a baby is born every 9.5 minutes. False. In Lee County, a family gets a new puppy every 9.5 minutes. False. In America, a person is infected with HIV every 9.5 minutes. Unfortunately, true. Learn the truth about HIV. Be positive you're negative. Get tested. If you are positive, get treated. For more information about testing and treatment, contact the McGregor Clinic in Fort Myers, 334-9555.
Hello, I'm Teresa Watkins Brown, candidate for re-election, Fort Myers City Council, Ward 1. Change is constant, but one thing that has not changed is my commitment to the Ward 1 community and building better communities in Ward 1. With over 35 projects that has improved our streetlights, sidewalks, parks, drainage, and sewage, I continue to be the voice that listen, act, and work for the Ward 1 community. We now have a newly renovated Billy Bowlegs Park and a future renovation for phase 2 of Roberta Clemente Park. that will house our Black Cultural Center. Continue to let me be the voice that speaks for you. Re-elect Teresa Watkins Brown, Fort Myers City Council, Ward 1. I am Teresa Watkins Brown, and I approve this message.
Join me. Call 239-281-0198.
Hey, friends.
Hey, how are you?
I'm fine. I just left my OB's office and they recommended a flu shot.
Oh, I got my flu shot last week. My doctor said it's the most important step in protecting myself against the flu, and it's safe for the baby too.
But I'm in my third trimester, so is it safe for me?
Of course. My doctor told me I can get it anytime while pregnant.
It's time to prevent the flu. Wash your hands with soap and water. Don't touch or shake hands with people who are sick. Clean and disinfect frequently. Cover your mouth and nose when you cough or sneeze. Stay home when you're sick and keep your children home when they're sick. For more information, visit FluFreeFlorida.com or the Lee County Health Department.
If you're looking for a sign to start fostering, well, this is it. Maybe you've thought about becoming a foster parent and said, someday. Maybe you've been waiting for the perfect time, the perfect partner, or the perfect job to help. But foster parenting isn't convenient. It's a calling that changes lives, starting with yours. So listen to your heart. The time to get serious about fostering is now. Visit ChildrensNetworkFlorida.org today and change a life for good.
You're listening to Lee Pitts Live on radio on WGGM 90.5 FM. The Haitian American Community Coalition is defined as what?
It is defined as a 501c3 organization that is here to promote awareness of the issues that are surrounding the Haitian community. We also are an organization that connects the Haitian community to local resources in our community. With the American community, we are considered as a bridge between the Haitian community and the American community. Mm-hmm. And people come into our office for resources and for us to connect them to resources in the community that they might not have been able to find on their own. Mm-hmm. And we also provide assistance with housing, Medicaid, if they need to apply for Medicaid, or if they need Obamacare medical insurance, we would also apply for those and be able to help our people with that. And you don't have to be Haitian to come into our office for us to connect you with local resources.
I'm going to come back to your office because I know you have a great business there too, and you didn't tell me to do that, but I'm going to come back to that. But I want to put a cap on this right quick. I know that you always have an outstanding reception at the gala. Mm-hmm. In the past, I've seen silent auctions going on and those types of things. And of course, Lee Pitts Live would be there doing interviews in the lobby. Tell us what's going to happen at the reception this year. The photos and everything will be pretty much like I've seen in the past?
Yes. We're going to have our silent auctions. We're also going to have vendor tables.
Okay.
The silent committee, we have a silent committee that is working on wonderful baskets. All the different baskets has a different theme, and they're going to be auctioned off at the event. So I would like to also plug in Jessica Vectorian, part of the silent auction committee, Marie Septis, part of the silent auction committee, and Pam Belford as part of the silent auction committee. They are doing a great job behind the scene working and having that available at the reception.
And if somebody right now is listening, they want to provide a product or a service or a hotel rooms or a vacation package or whatever to be a part of the silent auction, they can do that as well?
Yes, they can do that. They can call us. My number is 239 239- 878-5898 239-878-5898. We encourage people to reach out to donate silent auction items to this wonderful cause by providing scholarships to our Haitian heritage students.
And let everybody know that before you were famous, before...
Lee, why do you have to say before I was famous?
Before your organization was famous, about 8 years ago or so, you called me up and told me this organization was being formed. And the first television talk show that you guys were on was Lee Pitts Live before you were famous.
Yes, yes. And we continue to be on Lee Pitts Live. So therefore, yeah, so we never forget where we come from. And thank you for all your support that you have provided throughout the years to our organization.
And now that you're the Haitian Beyonce, we're so glad that you came back on the show.
Oh, my God. That's such a huge title. But thank you so much.
I hope that down the road you run for political office. I keep telling you that. That's another story. You are electable. We need great candidates.
Thank you.
But let's go back to your business. I'm so proud. I got a chance to come to your grand opening. Brought the TV show there.
Thank you.
It is so impressive. People can contact you. What's the name of that business and what services that you provide there?
Yes. I own Jaquette & Associates Bookkeeping and Business Services. We provide payroll services and bookkeeping services. And we work with a lot of small business owners to help them grow their business and to help them succeed.
And you are the president of the Haitian Community Coalition of Southwest Florida.
Yes.
I remember when you were the vice president. You've been the president for six years?
Yes.
4 years?
Yes, since 2015.
Okay, say something to me in Creole.
Eh bien, Lee.
Okay.
Qui so pensé?
Ça passe. I want you to take 30 seconds and in your French or Creole, look into that camera and invite everybody to the scholarship gala.
Mes amis, tout pep ayisyen nou yo nap tan nou nan 29 octobre. Lundi kap 21 octobre nan Broadway Palms, adres la se 1380 Colonial Boulevard. Si ou se ayisyen vini nan joua, vin sipote bon koz sa nap fè a, nou gen anpil ti moun ke, nou bay scholarship, nou gen anpil organizasyon nan joua ke nap recognize ki fè bon travay nan kominote a. Nap tan nou, e pa kite nou, m konen ke wap vini wap toujou sipote nou, paske toujou vini sipote nou, e nap tan nou ane sa nan gran chouz. Sonje make dat la, lundi kap 21 octobre 2021 à 5h dans Broadway Palms là. Ticket a sous besoin acheter ticket ou capable contacter ma 239 878 58 98. En même temps tout pas oublier pour voter année parce que nous gain general election année là qui dans novembre. T'as pas oublier pour faire ça. OK?
I
also plugged in about voting.
Be the same. Yeah. Oh, man, whatever. That sounds so good, though.
Thank you.
Hey, whatever she said, I agree with it 100%.
Thank you, Lee.
All right, bitch, it's always been a pleasure. Let me bump you out. Yeah. Remember, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like my good friend Beatrice. And Miami may have the oranges, but Gateway High School has got the...
juices.
Got the juice. We'll be right back.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Hi, I'm Kevin Boyd, Commander, American Legion, Post 38, downtown Fort Myers. We are proud of 100 years in the Fort Myers community. Our mission is clear, to support our veterans in a holistic way. Post 38 offers a wide range of services to veterans, such as assisting acquiring their DD-214, emergency assistance with utility bills and food. The general public can also utilize this wonderful facility for social events such as weddings, receptions, parties, meetings, and much more. We have a full-service kitchen and bar. Our parking holds over 100 cars. Inside capacity is 269. On Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., citizens can come and get a free bag of groceries. American Legion, Post 38, here for the community.
Hello, my name is Tracy McMillian. I'm the fire chief of the City of Fort Myers Fire Department. And one thing I'd like to actually just bring to your attention is a new technology that we have out in our fire department. It's called Community Connect. What we're trying to do is connect with you, our community. With this particular software, we have the opportunity to be able to know who lives in your residence, what type of dogs or animals who you have inside your home. So God forbid there's an emergency, we know what we're looking for. So if we know that you have a wife and two kids, we know, hey, look, where's mom? Where's dad? Where's the two kids? And if you have a little pet, we know to look for your pet as well. Community Connect is a great technology for us as a fire department for emergencies to be able to connect with you all and give you much better service. Please sign up for Community Connect. We're your local fire department and we care dearly about you.
Hello, I'm Amber Ware, Senior Center Manager for the City of Fort Myers STARS Division. At the City of Fort Myers STARS, we focus on education, recreation, wellness, and a holistic approach that engages the citizens of our Fort Myers community. Please join us as we continue to positively transform our community. We look forward to hearing from you. Drop by, call, or visit our website.
Hi, I'm Jeffrey Roberts.
And I'm Plachette Roberts.
And we are All America Social Security Disability Representation, LLC. With over 30 years of experience successfully representing clients nationally for disability benefits, we're here for you if you've ever been denied or in the process of applying.
This is not just our vocation, but also our ministry. We know that it's not only about your health and finances, but your spiritual and emotional needs as well.
For a free consultation, please call us at 720-475-0440.
You're listening to Lee Pitts Live on radio on WGGM 90.5 FM.
Good morning. My name is Tamika Seaton, Executive Consultant of Grow Your Nonprofit. Welcome to another edition of my segment where we help nonprofits raise more money through fundraising strategies, strategic plan, and so much more on Lee Pitts Live. Before we get started, I would like to thank the sponsors of my segment. Hodges University with a campus in Fort Myers. Stay near, go far. They change lives for the better. Trinity Life Foundation Naples, founded on the principle of making a difference in at-risk youth in Collier County. Vax Truths, founded by the Wellness Ministries of Emmanuel Communities, funded by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention to raise awareness of COVID-19 and the vaccine to reduce the health disparities in the minority communities, AVIN. That stands for the Association of Haitians Living Abroad for the Development. Founded to empower Haitian immigrants through financial literacy, education, and helping them gain access to community resources. Today, guys, you're in for a treat. My special guest is Will Bronson. He is the founder and president of Enlightened Education Co-op. It's a nonprofit based right here in Fort Myers. Welcome, Will.
Thank you, Tamika. It's good to be with you.
Thank you. Will, let's get started by you telling us a little bit about your background.
Well, I'm a retired airline pilot and also an academic, 3 graduate degrees and one in education, which is close to my heart because because of my connection with education, I decided after I retired not so many years ago, actually, I founded a nonprofit organization called Enlightened Education Co-op.
Yes, yes. And I know, what is the goal of the organization? What's the goal?
The goal is to support the public schools in our area and hopefully eventually throughout the country by hiring retired teachers to work on a part-time basis, 10 to 20 hours a week,
Okay.
And we intend to pay them with money we will raise from private sources. So it'll be a public-private partnership, and mm-hmm. we hope to pay them in the area of $25 an hour to serve as teacher assistants to those mm-hmm. struggling public school teachers that really need another adult in the classroom, let's mm-hmm. put it that way.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Hi, I'm Jeffrey Roberts.
And I'm Plachette Roberts.
And we are All America Social Security Disability Representation, LLC. With over 30 years of experience successfully representing clients nationally for disability benefits, we're here for you if you've ever been denied or in the process of applying.
This is not just our vocation, but also our ministry. We know that it's not only about your health and finances, but your spiritual and emotional needs as well.
For a free consultation, please call us at 720-475-0440.
Hello, my friends. Be sure to catch the historic Lee Pitts Live television show every Sunday morning at 6:30 a.m. on Wink CW Channel 6. That's the longest-running television talk show in the history of Southwest Florida. Now in our 30th year.
Hi, my name is Martin Bird Jr. Born and raised in the city of Fort Myers, I love this place. That is why I'm running for Ward 1, City of Fort Myers City Council. Multiple millions of dollars in fines and water issues, violence in the streets, and communities left behind. This is what experience has brought us. Better parks, entertainment, food options, affordable housing, and clean streets can be our experience. The old experience way hasn't worked. I am asking you to support me in creating a better way. Support Martin Bird Jr. for Fort Myers City Council, Ward 1. I am Martin Bird, and I would appreciate your vote. I approve this message.
You're listening to Lee Pitts Live on radio on WGGM 90.5 FM.
And when can we see that program roll out?
Well, we were planning on this fall, if we get the cooperation of the district, to place 10 teachers, which would be our first pilot program, in various schools around the district. And so we'd like to get started as soon as possible.
Okay, very, very good. So can you tell our audience, how would someone reach you if they wanted to get involved or just donate $1 million to you?
Sure. You can find our website at www.enlighteneducationcoop with a hyphen between the O's and co-op. Mm-hmm. We're a 501c3, so any contributions are tax deductible. You can donate online, or you can call me personally at my cell phone, which is 239-940-6080. Easy to remember.
Very good. Well, guys, that's my time. Thank you again, my special guest, Will, for joining us today and for your passion and knowledge in helping our children because they are our future. Mm-hmm. Be sure to visit Enlightened Education Co-op's website, as Will had mentioned. Are you a small startup or stagnant nonprofit who want to grow? Call me today at 239-293-2009 or visit our website at growyournonprofit.com. Stay tuned, and we'll be back with more Lee Pitts Live.
What a wonderful time enjoying our guest today. Boy, I have one of the coolest jobs in the world, talking to all of these fascinating people. And now, it has come to this, the end of this show. Not to worry, you can always catch us right here twice a day, weekdays from noon to 1 p.m. and from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. It's our daily family reunion right here on WGGM 90.5 FM. Be sure to catch our TV show, Lee Pitts Live, Sundays at 6 o'clock a.m. on Wink CW. That's Channel 6. Until next time, remember, Miami has the oranges, but Fort Myers got the juice. I'm Lee Pitts. Look forward to talking to you soon.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.